Hello, this is Linda Lou with Style with an Enophile. Today we are going to be discussing, or more or less, a show and tell of this amazing mascara that I was talking about earlier. It is also known as 3D Fiber Lash. Why 3D? Because it makes your eyelashes three times longer than your original lashes are. I know my lashes used to be wunderbar, but lately it has been reduced through probably age and other medical reasons. So when I discovered this wonderful fiber lash, I first asked, what is it made out of? Because I've done fiber lashes before. I used to use L'Oreal, I think it was called L'Oreal Fiber Lash. And normally when I go out with makeup and look hot and really like run around the town, the fibers would get into my eyes and it would really disturb my time. And that's very important because time is of the essence. And I just stopped using it. Then I used to do fake eyelashes, and I went through the whole, oh my god, it's coming off, or oh my god, it feels like it's coming off, but it's not really, oh my god, this glue is driving me nuts, it smells like stank. Then I went and bought the black glue, which was even more of a fiasco, got all over the place. And then, of course, trying to take it off at the end of the night, pulling it off, it was awful, and I'm sure I pulled off way too many lashes than I should have. So I gave up. I didn't want to do that anymore. And besides, it really does look fake. And then I thought about the Latisse, since that is also very popular. But I personally didn't feel comfortable with that because, you know, my father is dealing with glaucoma and he's losing his eyesight. And I just couldn't imagine using something that is novelty for something that he needs to be able to see family. I didn't feel comfortable with that. The other thing is extensions. I thought about it, but when I saw some pros and cons and I saw what it does to sometimes with lashes, I couldn't take a chance of any of my lashes leaving me prematurely. Secondly, the expense and the commitment of having artificial extensions was astronomical for me. The price is expensive and I could barely keep up with getting a gel nails done. So that is definitely more of a priority, is having my wonderful feet feel happy and my nails to look pretty good. So when this fiber lash came to my existence, I was innumerably excited and I used it and I loved it. And now I'm on my third month with it. I don't use it every day. I could, people could, but I'm lazy and I don't really get dressed up every day. Like today, I had a workshop all day, so I just put a really cute Harry Scary in my hair. This one's called a Calavera. It's a play on words. In honor of Frida Kahlo, notice the little flowers on the top, and she liked butterflies. And also, Calavera means skull, and it has a skull. So I thought that was kind of cute for having a little color. My hair is all frizzo. I just threw in a little bun, red lipstick, and 3D fiber lash. I only put it on one eye because I was also showing ladies at my workshop what it's about. Now, mind you, I have absolutely nothing on today. No foundation, no nothing, just the fiber lash, and it's pretty long. I liked it. Nothing long. Nothing long. So, I'm going to show you what it looks like. First, it comes in a beautiful case, nice hard case. You can put anything in it once you've decided to run out, because you've had how many months worth of the stuff. You can always take these things out and put jewelry in it. I've done that. I think it's a great travel case for jewelry. In any case, we are going to pull them out. Notice there are two sizes. I personally would like if they had maybe different color lids or something, but I'm pretty good at distinguishing the two sizes and knowing which is which, so I don't really screw up what goes into what. The first thing you do, Excuse me. I need to have a sippage. I will divulge what this is. It is wonderful. And it is in the Napa Valley. Next sip, I will tell you what it is. Okay, so the first thing is the gel. It is made out of a couple of ingredients, one of them being a collagen, and the other being a zinc oxide for the color. This company is very big on using natural items, and it's very gooey, glistening, extremely strong black. So you put it on your whole lid, eyelashes, and you coat it, and you make it nice and wet. And then you do one eye only, because you want to make sure it stays wet. And I go slowly. Many girls are like, oh, it gets so messy to put it on. Well, then why are you rushing? Slow down. Long strokes. I also tilt my head up, and then I go up. Because if you go like this, and when you're older, you have a little extra sag here. You don't want to be putting it on like this. And I see so many women go horizontally. Who puts mascara on horizontally? Vertical. You're creating length. Extend. Vertically. Brush. So once you put that on, like you're painting a beautiful painting vertically, then you put the little fuzzies on. I call them fuzzies, but they're really green tea fibers. And it is also dyed with zinc oxide, so it's natural. And you start with the mid to the top. I mostly stick with the top because I want to extend. I want length. And so again, I go slowly up until it builds length, up until you notice it doesn't build anymore. It starts to get a little clumpy, so you stop. Then you go back, and I keep them both in my hands like this. Then you go back, and long, strong strokes to coat it again and smooth it out. Smells good. Smooth it out, and then you notice that you have long lashes. Now, if you really want to go, hey, you put two coats. So you do your next eye. Then once that eye is done, you go back to the original eye and you do the gel again. Long strokes. Fibers, and you'll notice it actually then becomes more thickening. Your eyelashes get thicker, and you go higher up, but don't do too much. I do see too many ladies do that spider eye look, or they think more is better. Sometimes more is definitely not better. Ladies, you know what I mean. So you do the same process. I personally would think two coats is plenty for creating a sexy look. Like my wonderful hair today is just fabulously sexy. So it's time for another sip, isn't it? So here we have a wonderful Meritage. It is made by a winery in Napa area, specifically the Calistoga area. And I discovered it by traveling to the famous Chateau Montelena, beautiful place. You must go. The garden is gorgeous, very Japanese. Influenced. Always inhale as you slowly sip. Always inhale. Olfactory must be working to really get the full sense of the sweetness and the beautiful candy of it all. So here is the bottle. I'm sorry, but you cannot get it. This is their special family label they had made. It's already sold out, but you can order their wines, other wines that are wunderbar. I think there's Zinfandel's grape. But it's a Meritage that includes a blend of Merlot, Cabernet, Cab Franc, Petit Verdot. It is really, really yummy and good for wonderful evenings with red lipstick.